Yeah, hello scrappers. Back out here at the melting pot. I sold another 10 pound lot of ingots yesterday. Got them packaged and off to the post office. So that leaves me two 10 pound lots left plus the 37 pounder. So I get out here and try to melt out some of this stuff. I'm thinking about tossing this in to start with and probably this one here. I have run into a little die cast, a little zinc out here, so I got my copper sulfate solution and grinder out here so I can test them. Looks like we've got a little metal plate on the bottom of this one. I'm gonna set that one in kind of like that where the And we'll set this one kind of off to the side a little bit. And maybe I'll throw something else in. I'll just have to check. So, I'm going to put this in the tripod. And go ahead and fire this puppy up. I got my blowtorch hooked up. That way if I have to heat up the drain hole, I can. Okay, let's see. I get this stuff out of the way here. I don't know if I can see in this. Yeah, I think you're in view. Get open the open the valve of the propane tank.
Well, we're in way up the line. Now it's nice and warm out here, just that fast, and we're already running on straight waste oil and compressed air. Flame doesn't look like much, but it does the job once it gets heated up. I'll throw a couple plates up on top to kind of help hold the heat in, and I'll pause the camera until we start getting some drip action. I'm probably only going to run the one camera today so I can get something done. It's already after 2 o'clock, so.
Yeah, hello, scrappers. Back again. It's Wednesday. It was Monday when I first started this video. I was going to get out and do this yesterday, but Social Security checks came in, so the wife and I went running around doing some shopping. So I'm by Harbor Freight and then Walmart and a few other places. So fixing to get ready to melt these cupcake ingots down. That's what I melted down Monday. I think there's about 41 pounds. So pretty productive day. You can see the back side there is kind of getting melted out. So once we start getting some warm weather where we're going to have several days above freezing, I'll mix up, I got some powdered refractory, and I'll mix some of that up and try to fill that hole in. Either that or I'm thinking about just getting I got a propane bottle. I may just start cutting it down and mix that refractory up and just to make me another furnace, probably a little smaller. I still got some of the cardboard tube left that I used to make, you know, to form my hole. So I'll have to cut open a propane bottle and see what it looks like inside of that. But when I do the propane bottle, I may put a hinge on it where I can just flip it open instead of having to pick it up and remove it. And then just retire this one. I'll put this one on a little cart so I can roll it around even, make it easy. Then I'm kind of wanting to move this whole operation over here to the south side where I can try to put a roof over it. I was going to do it here, but man, that's a lot of work. You know, which I could use the extra storage space for sure. Dry storage, or semi-dry, may have a few leaks, who knows, using used metal. So yeah, anyway, I'm gonna put this in the tripod and grab the torch and fire this thing up, let it start producing some heat. It takes a while to get all that mess heated up. I think you can see what I'm doing on the controls and everything there. When's it gonna light up? That 1 pound canister had been feeling empty for a long time, but it just keeps going and going and going. I did buy another one of those cheap $20 Harbor Freight self-ignited torches yesterday. I tried that out. Man, that thing's got a flame on it. So you can kind of see that going in there right now. I do have a small bucket in here that I want to kind of work out. Lights. I got this thin little ingot here. I'll go ahead and remelt it. And then I got, you know, some of these other ingots. They've all got little gas bubbles in them, I guess. So I thought, you know, I might mix one of those into each batch. So we'll go ahead and take it out here. And I'll load the crucible and we'll go ahead and throw that in there. That should be more than enough. I'm not sure if you can see that swirl action, but it's got a good swirl action going on right there. Who knows, I could probably melt aluminum right on its own. But I'm gonna, yeah, I'll go ahead and see if we can fire it up, get some. We've already got oil up there. Our line's already black. I need to buy some more of that tubing just to have it on hand. If that tubing gets brittle and starts breaking up, I'll have to replace it. Just 1/4 inch. Okay, propane is all the way off. So now the flame looks tiny. But give it a little bit and it'll be doing real good. So I'll go ahead and pause the camera. We'll pick it up here in a little bit.
I'm getting 2 pounds per batch. I have to do about 20 pounds or 20 batches to get 40 pounds. And vegetable oil catching on fire.
pulling no tail. Yeah, you're a good kitty.
Well, that was a lot of fun. Ended up being, I did pretty much one scorpion coin per batch, except on the very last batch, so be about 17 batches. Took an hour pause in there to go help my son-in-law put a hot water tank in, and then came back out here for an hour, and then the wife called me for dinner. So yeah, a few interruptions. It's almost 6 o'clock now, so got it done. So I'll have to get a weight on it, and I'll probably put that, whatever the weight is, I'll try to add that to the description, video description, or I'll put it in the title, one or the other. But I'm getting everything covered up. Here's Oreo over there, getting all covered up. I got to get all these ingots in pretty quick before it rains. It's supposed to rain tonight. It's supposed to have thunderstorms again. Gotta get this raised up here. Get raised up where it'll run into the siphon, or drain back into my jug. It's been a pretty good day for melting. Good warm weather. It's real calm right now. Had a little bit of wind earlier, so not too shabby. But I think the last time I melted a bunch of these ingots, someone commented they wanted to see the pile. So there it is. Pretty good little pile. I know I don't want to try to pick it up and carry it in all at once, so I'll load up that basket there or something like that and carry them in and dump them in the other basket, make two or three trips. Be good enough. I'll have to take all these coins in and take the jeweler's saw to them, clean them up, and take them to the bench grinder and clean them up a little bit. I've been throwing one of them in with every one of my, one or two of them in with each ingot order. Give them a little bonus. May have to buy another coin mold, something other than the scorpion. I need to have one made with the Okie scrapper logo on it. Well, I'm going to get off of here. I want to remind everybody about the Amazon affiliate link. There's a lot of consumables and different tools we use on there that you might find convenient and handy to use. I know I got several of my subscribers are using the Go Yonder cutting discs. They work real well, and that helps support the channel. Of course, I won't turn down a super thanks or something like that, or you can always buy me a cup of coffee too, but don't feel you have to. But these ingots have been selling pretty good for February. I bet I made over $100 on ingots this month, so I can't complain there. Of course, I figure for my time, I'm making about 10 bucks an hour, but yeah, I don't have to make good money. I'm retired. Got my Social Security coming in. I got to get the tractor parked too. And my daughter's trailer, hot water tank's on the back side of it, and about 3 foot of skirting, so I just took the end off of that bin there and let him work in that, raised him up there. Here's a little idea I've came up with for anybody, any of you guys that refill your propane bottles, your small ones. If you get an old turkey fryer like this, just take it apart and the tank sits up there upside down real nice in it. So then you can reach in and turn the valve on and off as you need to. I've got one of them little fittings that go up in there, and sticks out in the tank's horizontal, but I'm really thinking about getting I think it's on a 2 foot, 3 foot hose, and then you can set the bottle on it. So you can actually have the bottle vertical and maybe have a lower table of this up on a higher table, and then have a lower table or something. So, but I'm thinking, I don't really use those little bottles all that much. Of course, if I could refill them, or
refill them like this, or, you know, low cost, I might start using it more. But I got that little buddy heater out in the fifth wheel, and that little buddy heater will keep it warm. And I got it hooked to a 20-pound tank. I've got 16 of these 20-pound tanks, so yeah, I'm not hurting for propane tanks. And right now, I think I got about 8 of them full. So, and a lot of them are partially full. I think that one I just brought out and it's full. That one's getting close to empty. I think I got 2 to exchange right now. I just had 4 filled. When I exchange them, it's $16.99 and you get like 15 pounds. And I didn't really notice the cost on filling them, but you get 20 pounds when you fill them. And I think it's probably about the same, probably about $17, $18. So I'm actually getting, you get more when you refill them. So I'm trying to get all these. What I do when they get 12 years, whatever the date is on them, and then whenever it exceeds that date, I exchange it. And then once I got one that's within date, then I get them filled. So you can see I had a bunch that were out of date, but can't complain. I'm getting them free. But, you know, picking them up as scrap, and sometimes they're even full of propane. But hey, I'm gonna get off of here. You guys have a great evening or day, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.